What would you say is the biggest takeaway or key point for asset managers from the regulatory outlook panel today?
What I found the most pertinent actually from the regulatory panel and my key takeaways is actually the regulators did agree that we have had a deluge of regulation. They did stand their ground and they did say, well, it was necessary regulation and important, and of course it is, and I think our clients understand that. But there was an acknowledgement and an acceptance that perhaps there wouldn't be the same volume and the same speed of regulation as there has been over the past few years. Now, only time will tell if that's the case, but at least they have acknowledged that, and I think that's a good starting point. It was very interesting on the exchange-traded funds industry, but the fact that the industry, the ETF industry, needs to have a greater voice. And when the regulator asked them questions about ETF structures or how the market operates or the liquidity of how APs generate liquidity, then those answers need to be very clear to the regulators so that they feel more comfortable with the regime. So I think that's a good takeaway. That make sure that whatever industry you're in, whether it's ETFs, whether it's private equity, hedge funds or credit funds, make sure that when there is a new regulatory development being introduced that you have a voice and you get that voice out there early. Now, again, is that through industry associations or is it individually? It could be a combination. The regulators are basically saying, we just need to hear from you. So I think the asset management industry as a whole needs to take that into account. I don't think that's the end of the story, but I think the fact that there's an acknowledgement and a public acknowledgement from the AMF that delegation is something that perhaps is not going to be fundamentally changed is useful. For me, the ESA review was, again, interesting. We had the voices of the CSSF, CBI, and actually also from Germany, the Ministry of Finance, basically turning around and saying, okay, we understand why the ESA review may need to happen. However, we don't necessarily agree with the detail of the ESA review. We don't necessarily think that just because there is some merit in operational efficiencies that you need to be in a place where you only have six people looking at these regulations. So I think, again, it's one to wait and see, and one certainly we at Dechert will be tracking within our global network, but one that at least clients know there's no one singular voice that causes uncertainty, but there is an inkling of hope there that it's not necessarily, again, a deluge of ESMA regulation.